going live?
Yeah, I always do this live, man. This okay. isn't pre-recorded.
All right, perfect.
This is... right now. That's what it is. Hey, everybody. It's Chris Ward here, Eagle Realty, North Myrtle Beach. We are doing it live here at Nacho Hippo with another edition of Talking Tech and Tacos. I actually got a guest with me this time, Mr. Nick Sowers.
How you doing?
What's going on? Beach Connection Realty, yep. Crescent Coast Insurance. Any other companies you want to throw in there?
Nah, we don't have to do anymore
today. Let's do a couple of those. He's getting ready. He's not being patient with the taco eating at the moment, but he's going to go ahead and diving in with our tacos. But he's going to help me talk about, we got a little bit of a an app that we're going to kind of dissect. I think it's one of his favorite apps, honestly, and he's the one who told me about it. I didn't even know about it, honestly. It was not something I used. I don't equate it. Well, we'll debate about the socialness of the app, but yeah, and then we're gonna talk about some tacos. And when Savannah, well here, we're just gonna do it like, let's just do it like this, because then they can hear me a little bit better, because if you pull it way back there, then they might not be able to hear me with that. So I'll just hold it and let you actually enjoy talking. All right, so the app, Mr. Sowers, is called Marco Polo.
Yes.
Marco Polo.
Yes, I use Marco Polo often.
Use Marco Polo. So this app, you can go download it on the App Store. It's a Marco, just Marco Polo, M-A-R-C-O, yep. Polo. And it is a video communication app, right?
Yes, I call it a video text message is what it is, because it's a very simple to use app. You just hit somebody's name, bam, start recording, and then hit stop, and it's sent to them instantly. So, and then they reply to you. So I use it a lot. I actually use it in business. I communicate with our contractor that way, that's working on properties we have. I also communicate with some of my business partners, and then I also find if you got something really short to tell somebody, using that app is way faster than busting out a text message. So,
now how would it compare to like a Snapchat or like, I mean, any other, almost all platforms have some kind of video interaction, some kind of video, you know, that you can send it back, a Facebook message, even a text. I mean, even you can send a video through text message, even in that kind of stuff. So what makes it better?
Well, I think the simplicity of it. I find when I try to send a video through text message or through another platform, there's a lot more button pushing to get there. I find on Marco Polo, it's just the simplicity of it. It's just real simple. Bam, 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 like four clicks, you're done. You sent your video. You don't have to worry about attaching it or anything like that. It's just there. It's in it. It's done.
So do you equate it? So you see it more as a tool. It's not really like a social platform.
Correct.
Tool, that kind of stuff. Or
yeah,
media
I see
platform.
It as, I see it big time as a tool.
Okay.
I don't see... The only social aspect of it is it pulls from your contact list. So that's you can't basically Marco Polo a stranger. So it has to be people in your existing contact list.
Gotcha. And you can do group chats too.
Yes,
you
like absolutely can. Thing. Yeah. Multiple people in there. I think we had 6 on one Marco Polo the other day. So.
Okay. All right. So Marco Polo being a video communication, but it's only video, no text, no like message like Snapchat where I can send a video but then I can send a text or I can send a GIF and I can like work down. It's only
all video.
Only video.
It's all video.
Okay.
So.
All right. Which I like the personal touch. I mean, obviously we're doing video here. You know, video is what it is the now, the culture of communication on that platform or that medium of communication as well. But I wonder how popular, like, are you finding a lot of people have it? So you, like I said, it pulls from your contacts. So it's got to tell you.
Yep. And I find more and more people have it than I thought. Let's put it that way. I thought I'd like, oh wow, I'm just gonna find like 3 or 4 people that use it. Instead, I probably got 10 people that probably somewhere between. I would say 15 people I communicate on a weekly basis via it. At least. I may not be every day, but it's at least once or twice a week we're communicating, and then other people it's daily.
He sends me a bunch.
And he loves it. He loves it. And so yeah, I mean, I think it's highly useful, and it's actually a really useful way if you want, got to send that text, and I'm not promoting this in any way, but while driving, it's a whole lot easier to use that than it is to actually type out a text message. So
at least you keep your eyes up, kind of at the road. Don't do that. Don't Marco Polo and drive. Start a hashtag, no Marco Polo and driving. But better than texting. Don't text about either. So, okay. Well, that makes sense. So Marco Polo, go check it out. Go check out the app on the App Store. Yep. See how you like and your friends. I don't have any demographical studies of like, you know, who's using it, what age groups are using it. For business, I mean, it sometimes makes sense because there's a lot of communication that happens on a face to face and body language and that kind of thing that communicate a message that you can't really get through a text or an email.
Yep. And I'll give you another good example. When we have in real estate, you're walking to a property and you see something, well, you can video it right there while you're talking, bam, send it directly to somebody. Hey, this needs fixed, or hey, this is hey, I saw this, communicate with another agent. It's just a real simple app to use
It's a one way to an extent, because yep. like you can't, it's not like face, like I can FaceTime my client and walk yep. through the property with them, but I'm interviewing, it's not yep. a phone call. This is more just, hey, I need a quick message. So it's
yes, this is I find it for very quick stuff.
That's a really loud plane going overhead, if y'all can hear that. Or helicopter. Yep. Or it's landing right here. I don't know what's going on. The walls are shaking.
Awesome.
All right. Hopefully that's gone. All right. Now you can hear us back. So, Marco Polo. Yep. Okay, but we're here at Nacho Hippo too, so obviously talking tech and tacos. Again, go check out Marco Polo. You can leave some comments, leave some feedback. Let me know how you feel about the app or if you use it or not like that. But we're also going to talk about some tacos right here. So I'm going to flip this around. What are you eating? What tacos do we have?
I'm eating the beef taco right now. I also got the chicken. Yeah, like I'm hammering this out right now. Like,
so a beef.
You want me to break this down for you?
What do we got?
So this is a beef gringo taco right here. The beef has good flavor, excellent flavor. The veggies are proportioned well onto the taco. I'm impressed here. So, and the tortilla was warm. I mean, it's in good. I mean, they knocked it out today. Nice. I will say that. Nice. They knocked out the beef taco.
Did you get two of the same?
No, I got the chicken as well.
Right, I'll wait till you get to that one. Yeah. I also actually got a gringo taco, I think with the beef as well. Got the gringo right here, so I'm going to take a little bite.
What do you think?
No, that's not bad.
That's,
yeah. Definitely fresher than, like, I mean, it's better than my beef tacos taste at home. My foot's stuck in this chair. Oh, there you go. Yeah, that was pretty good. I kind of mixed it up there. What did you say the other one was? Chicken?
Yeah, I got the chicken.
So you stayed pretty safe with chicken and beef. I kind of went with a blackened fish Baja taco. I think they call it the Baja. And then the gringo. They have the cool names of tacos here at Nacho Hippo.
Yeah.
Or at the Nacho Hippo in North Myrtle Beach, in case you didn't catch that.
They also, here's the other thing I'll say about their tacos.
Okay, go ahead.
I got some good taco feedback. I wouldn't call this a place you come if you want to get something that's real authentic Mexican-style tacos. This is more definitely an Americanized taco joint.
Americanized taco. Well, do we really have that many Mexican-style taco joints down here? Like, I mean, like authentic? I wonder how many we have.
There's a few.
I'd have to go search.
There's a few. I know of a few, so.
Okay. All right. Yep. Now, do you use hot sauce?
No, I don't.
Okay. I do. I'm going to get a little bit of flavor on that. Oh, truly, I got the platter here with rice. So you don't have to watch me eat both tacos. I'm going to go ahead and try also the Baja taco, which, let's be honest, is one of my favorite tacos here. As long as it's to the standard hipster. It's a fish taco. It's like one of the most popular tacos.
It's a hipster fish taco.
But that's the quality. It's quality I've come to expect from it. So that's why I get it every time. Is the blackened fish taco really good? Love the sauce. Very simple. Just one fillet of fish on there. I mean, it's just easy. It makes sense to me. I don't know why eating fish is hipster.
But you didn't get the chicken, though, did you?
No, I got the beef, though. Yeah, beef gringo.
Beef, okay.
Yeah. Beef gringo with that. All right, so I want to thank my guest, Nick Sowers, for joining me here on Talking Tech and Tacos, another edition. Every Tuesday, or as many Tuesdays as we can make it, we're going to try this out, talking about tech and tacos. Have some fun. Sometimes we have guests, sometimes we won't, but we'll still have fun every week. So let me know if you have any kind of tech, apps, tools, resources, doesn't have to be real estate related. You can definitely send a comment below and let me know, and I would love to review or talk about them. So I will check you out next time for Talking Tech and Tacos. Peace out.